Have you ever wondered why classrooms get messy so quickly? It's because we have 25 plus humans in one room. No wonder that stuff is everywhere. So how are teachers supposed to contain all the stuff? Well, in this video, I'm going to share with you how I keep my classroom looking organized, and these are things that you can do in your classroom right now. Welcome back. I'm Rachel Vincent, and I share tips on how to run an effective and efficient classroom so that you can get more done and still have time to teach. My number one tip is to contain the stuff. Their teachers will walk in my classroom all the time and tell me that my classroom looks so neat and organized. But in reality, all I've done is just hid my mess. I have contained it so when someone walks in, it looks clean and organized, but it actually is just hiding behind tubs and drawers and baskets. Whatever container you want to use, and I use a variety of containers, but contain your mess, for lack of a better word. I personally like to use drawers to put all of my paperwork in, whether it's future copies for future lessons, or papers I need to grade, or things I need to file later, or even just that random paperwork that comes from the office. I just slide it in a drawer and now nobody can see it as messy. The biggest culprit for having messy places are flat surfaces. So if you have a teacher desk or a small group table, I guarantee you that is one of your messiest places in your classroom because it's so easy for things to pile up and for you to put things on flat surfaces. You don't have to change your whole organization system. Think about where is a messy place? So let's say, for instance, it is your small group table. What kind of container, drawer, basket, tub can you put in that same place to put all of your papers or stuff in? One of the areas I noticed in my classroom last year that was getting quite messy a lot was where the pencil sharpener and pencil cups were. So this summer I bought a plastic serving tray that now is what holds our pencil sharpener and our dull and sharp pencil cups so that they get replaced or put back or kept in that same spot every time. I'm not constantly having to move things back where they belong. And this leads into my second tip, which is everything needs a place. We know as teachers, the big things need a place like supplies and paperwork, but even all the little things need a place too. One of the things I like to use is a teacher toolbox. It keeps all of those little supplies in a place to where I can find them quickly. And when I have paper clips left on my table after making copies or grading papers, I have a place where they can go immediately so it's not cluttering up my space. Dry erase markers, it may seem simple, but when they're all strewn across your chalkboard tray, it looks messy. So when you put it into a container, everything looks a little more neat and tidy. Plus, storing them upside down actually helps you because then all of the ink is at the tip, so when you go to write, it feels like a brand new marker. Even having a little container for missing pieces. It's inevitable that after students have used math manipulatives or played a game or worked in a center and they've cleaned up, there's always one or two pieces that got missed. It's under somebody's table, it's found later, and of course the student brings it to you when you don't have the time to go and put it back where in its proper place. So having a container for missing pieces, you can just drop that in there, you know where to find it if you need it in the future, and then when you do have time to clean up and put it back in its proper place, you know where it's at. No matter how many times I ask my students to keep up with their belongings, there are always pencils and crayons and glue sticks galore on the floor. So at the end of the day, when students are cleaning up and packing up, again, it doesn't matter how many times you ask, who does this belong to? Nobody seems to know. Nobody is missing glue until we need to actually glue something. So all of those items get put into our lost property container. That way, when it is time for that lesson where we need glue, and all of a sudden, three students don't have glue, I tell them to go check the lost property container. And then typically right before a break or after, let's be honest, an extended period of time, because I don't do this regularly, we'll go through pull out the lost property container. I will physically walk around so everyone can look to see if anything belongs to them. And often they find something, but there's always crayons and pencils and things like that left over. Pencils get put into our pencil cups, but then any non-broken crayons go into our extra crayon container. This container is perfect for all of those crayons that never seem to have a home, but also when students need a certain color because theirs is missing, I have a place for them to go so they can find one. The third thing for keeping your classroom organized is to set aside time to tidy up. Whether it's one afternoon you stay a few minutes after school to reset your space, or you do it while the students are cleaning up and packing up, whatever that time is, it is inevitable that throughout your day, you will not be putting things back in their proper place. So if you have a place for everything, tidying up actually doesn't take you that long. What takes a long time is when you don't have a proper system in place and you don't know where things belong. Another way that I make sure that our classroom gets tidy is it is part of our student jobs. One of my classroom jobs is actually called an aesthetic assistant. This person is actually responsible for walking around the room and tidying up, making sure the pillows on our couch look nice and neat, stacking up the guided reading table stools, just making sure that things get back in their proper place. Our librarians are responsible for making sure our books look nice and neat and dusting the shelves. So I put a lot of that responsibility on my students to help take care of the classroom because it's not just my classroom, it's our classroom. When students are doing their jobs, I am also tidying up my area. So I'm cleaning up those stacks of papers, those papers we didn't get to, I'm gonna put them back into our subject drawer, or if they're just extra copies that didn't get passed out, I'm either going to set them aside for an absent student, or if they're just extra, I have an extra copies drawer so that when somebody loses their paper or I need an extra copy, I know where to go to look for it. I'm gonna put those paper clips away, those pens and markers that I've used throughout the day, and just tidy up my area so that it is nice and ready for the next day. Organization isn't something that you can just do once and then check off your to-do list. It requires you to use the systems that you have set in place. And if that system isn't working for you, change it until you can figure out what works for you and your classroom. After you get your space organized, the next step is to get your students organized. Click on the video that's on your screen now for tips on how to help your students stay organized. I'll see you over there.